Hello everyone, welcome back to Sabir Cat. Hope all are doing fine. This is my second video on why I love polylines. Hope you have already gone through my first video. If you have missed my first video, please click on the link provided at the upper right corner of this video. In this video, I'll teach you how to create a 3D pipeline using polylines as path curves. But you know that polylines are confined to 2D planes, and that's the limitation of a polyline. So how do you overcome this limitation to create a 3D path? We can easily find a solution for that. I'll also demonstrate the polyline option in the fillet command, which is a feature I love. Then after creating the 3D pipeline, we will change its diameter in one click. So let's get started. First of all, I'll change my view to southwest isometric. So I'll click on this hotspot of the view cube. Next, I'll create a polyline using the polyline command in the XY plane. Polylines can only be created on the XY plane. So I'll pick a number of random points after turning on the ortho mode. I'm not going to give any dimensions. When you try, you can give dimensions as per your requirement. Next, I would like to construct a polyline in a different plane, that is XZ plane. You know that XZ plane is parallel to the front face. When you look at the view cube, you can see that this is the front, this is the left, and this is the top face. The various faces of an object can be identified using view cube as a reference. That means I want to align the UCS parallel to the front face. So I'll go to Visualize tab. I'll click on this pop-up on the coordinate panel and click on the front face. Now the XY plane is aligned with the front face. Next, I'll continue creating polylines from here, like this. Now we have polylines in two different planes. Next, I'll use one of my favorite feature in fillet command, which is the polyline option. So I'll click on the fillet command and I'll click on radius. I'll pick two points to specify the radius so that the distance between these two points will be taken as a radius, and click on polyline option and click on this polyline. And you can see that the corners got filleted in one click. Next, I'll repeat the fillet command, then click on polyline again and click on this polyline. Now you can see that both these polylines got filleted. But what about this particular corner? We have to create a fillet between two polylines which are in two different planes. You know that this plane is parallel to the left face, so I'll click on the Visualize tab, then click on this pop-up list and click on left to align the UCS on this left plane. Next, I'll click on polyline and I'll create a polyline from this endpoint to this endpoint to this endpoint. Next, I'll click on fillet again and I'll click on polyline and select this polyline to fillet it. Next, I have to erase this excess portion which is extended beyond this arc. If I select this polyline, the entire polyline will get selected and erased. What I'll do is I'll give explode command by typing X using the keyboard. Then I'll select these polylines to explode. Next, I'll click on erase command and erase these two segments. Next, using the join command, I'm going to join all these objects as a single object. So I'll click on the modify panel and I'll click on join command, or else you can type the letter J using the keyboard, and I'll select the entire objects and give an enter. Now when you click on this object, you can see that it's a single object, but it is converted as a spline. Next, I'll create a circle, and the radius of the circle will be the outer radius of the pipe. Next, I'll click on the sweep command and select the circle, then give enter. When I'm asked to give the sweep path, I'll select the spline. Now I'll change the visual style to shaded with edges, and you can see that you have created a pipeline. Next, I'll create a shell thickness on this pipeline. For that, I'll click on the shell command and select this object. Now I'm asked to select the faces to be removed. I'll click on this end face as well as this end face. Now I'll give an enter. Next, I'm asked to give an offset distance. I'll just zoom in and pick a point straight down and you can see the values changing. It's around 0.0176. Just pick a point here. Now let's change the diameter of this 3D pipeline. For that, I'll click on the offset phases option in the solid editing panel, and I'll click on the inside phase, give an enter. Now I'm asked to give an offset distance. I'll give an offset distance of 0.025. And I'll give an enter. Now you can see that you have changed the diameter of the 3D pipeline in one click. How do you find this video? Please hit the like button if you liked it. And drop your valuable comments and suggestions at the comment box below. And subscribe to my channel SabirCAD if you are not a subscriber already. And hit the bell icon and all that so that you will get alerts and updates whenever I upload a new video. So that's all for now. Until I catch you with another informative video on Why I Love Series. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.